read in the paper that Mayor Keyser has announced September 12th, Lucy's Love Bus Day forevermore.
This bus I've been wanting for about 4 years. The challenge for us is convincing doctors that these therapies help children. When Lucy was 8 and getting acupuncture all the time, the doctors would say, you know, why does a child with leukemia want to be poked with needles when you've been poked with needles all day? And she would say, just try it.
Lucy's Love Bus was formed back when before Lucy died. She wanted to help kids with cancer.
She kind of like kept the same spirit throughout her whole life, even though she was sick, because she kind of knew that throughout her life she was going to like do something that was going to help people.
You like feel like a lot closer to like and like understand what all the kids go through when you can like do something like this.
Beecher wanted to do this Flyaway Festival, so since January we've been working real hard to raise money and create this festival. And all the money that we raise goes to integrative therapies to help children with cancer, like acupuncture and Reiki. We also do other stuff like horseback riding to help children with cancer, music therapy.
I wanted to share with you a story of Lucy. And what had happened was shortly before Lucy died, she wrote a letter, and these are her words. She said, "When you are looking at sick children, follow them to a place they can speak to you in. Notice their bodies are two things, love and illness. And help those children remember the love and not the sadness. The healing is in knowing who you were, not what you might be."
The song you're about to hear was written by Beecher, and I just wanted to put some music to it. So in honor of Lucy, I'd like to go ahead and sing this song. We call it Lucy's Song.
Singing to my baby's ear, my voice was calling strong and clear. I'm right here, oh, I'm right here. Singing to my baby's ear, my voice was calling strong and clear. I'm right here, oh.
To everyone, including the media, for supporting us. Say, you rock.
You rock.
All right, let's hear it for Eli.
This is Amrick Lewis. I'm here with the group of Mayor and Beecher. What brought you guys out to support this event?
Lucy. I mean, it's all about, you know, remembering the life.
Celebrating.
Yeah, it's a great event. You know, we're going to release how many butterflies today?
1,200.
1,198.
Two of them got away.
Oh, did they?
They're down in Worcester now. Yeah. They've been texting me. Yeah, they're good.
So I painted my face to represent one of them. So.
Yeah. Right. We met someone earlier today that really, really touched our heart. We wanted to bring her on stage with us. Come on, Miranda.
It was my friend's birthday, and I was outside at recess with her. And I was giving her a card when I found a butterfly on the ground, and its wing was broken, and I was afraid it was going to get stepped on, and I really like butterflies, and I would be really sad if I saw that it was dead. So I took the card that I gave my friend, and I scooped the butterfly up onto the card, and I walked as fast as I could over to where there was a lot of bushes. I put it behind the fence in the bushes where kids wouldn't be able to step on it. And then I had a bag of Doritos in my pocket, so I took a Dorito and I put it next to the butterfly so it had some food.
If Doritos are listening, y'all need to give her a full sponsorship for putting y'all on like that. She said a butterfly piece of your potato chip. Give it up for Miranda, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
sure I brought my ibuprofen because I heard that butterflies give you migraines. Is that true? No. What? Oh, they migrate. Oh, well, that was a waste of money.
Which is www.LucysLoveBus.org.